let me ask you a different question. Can we move on to another topic?
Yeah, sure.
I wonder what your thinking is on, you know, we might possibly, right now we don't know who's the president of the USA in the next election, okay? So right now it's looking like Romney versus Obama. And Romney is a Mormon, and I guess he used to be a high leader in his church. I don't know if you know that or not. He was like a bishop or something. He was a stake person, president or something. I don't know. He was really high up there. So, you know, one thing I'm thinking is it kind of scares me that somebody, you know, for the commander-in-chief, for the America is the most strongest nation on earth. We have the most influence. Do we want to have somebody in there that cannot think critically? And when it comes to Mormonism, if you look at that faith, it seems like it's the easiest thing to debunk because it's kind of newer. But one of the major things is that Joseph Smith claimed that to translate this book, it's called the Book of Abraham, and it turned out that nobody could read Egyptian at that time, and so he got away with saying this is the Book of Abraham, and now people can read Egyptian, and they say no, that's called the Book of Breathings. It's an Egyptian funeral text. So Joseph Smith got caught lying. And so this whole faith is built upon a lying prophet. And so, you know, the most important thing to you is probably your belief. And, you know, if you can't critically examine that when it's easy to disallow, how else can you make other decisions, like on the economy, on should we bomb Iran or North Korea or defend Israel? I mean, all these things, you really want to have somebody that can think critically and not just...
Well, okay, I don't know if he's lock, stock, and barrel on Mormonism, but... you know, this goes back to what I was saying earlier about Jesus saying we should have unity. You know, the bottom line is having faith in Jesus and the Bible. That's the bottom line. And yes, that's a religion. And to me, it's the truth, though. All this other theology, we're not trying to elect a theologian in chief. You know, all we're trying to elect somebody who can greatly do the job of a president. You know, which we have a real bad one now. Statistically, we can show that. So we need somebody, and Romney's got a great record in economics. So that's what we really want. We want somebody who's sufficient economically, and has a plan to help the country in the job they're in. I mean, they keep saying, okay, Obama's a nice family man. Well, I'm sure you're a nice family man too. But would you say that would qualify you to be president, you know, as far as like running an economic system? So therefore, you know, it's a mess out there politically to me. But what it comes down to is president is a job. And what we want is somebody who can do the job well. And, you know, right now we have a bunch of sound bites flying at each other, you know, attack ads. And it's really unfortunate. But I think Romney would do a way better job.
But, you know... To some extent, I mean, you know, in America, we don't like to talk about religion. They say we should keep religion out of it and things. But, you know, if this person came forward and said, I believe in Zeus, you know, some ancient mythology, obviously you would say, well, there's a problem there because he believes in that. Or what if he believed in astrology? He believed in reading the stars for his future.
Well, okay.
We would say, whoa. Or okay. What if he believed in a flat earth? We would say, whoa.
Yeah, well, those are extremes, but
why isn't Mormonism extreme too? I mean, it's so easy to debunk.
Well, because like once I said, the theological backs and forths aren't important. But you know, I mean, what it comes down to is that secular humanism is a religion too. I mean, as defined, it's defined in the dictionary as a religion. And what is a religion? Basically, has two things. A religion defines morals. And it defines existence. Okay, so the morals of a secular humanist basically are political correctness, and so you have Obama in this position, and then existence is defined by science, you know, supposed modern science. So I would like somebody in office who would devoid themselves of those things, you know, who would just be, how am I going to be a good president? What is the job requirement, and can I do it well? And that's what I would want in a president.
Okay, but you know, like I said before, though, the religion is your most personal thing. You know, it's the most important thing in your life, especially when, you know, if there's eternal stakes, you know, you have to believe this and you go into heaven, or this or you go to hell or something.
Well, but see, then what it comes down to again is that So therefore, secular humanism is a bad religion because of the social statistics and the entertainment, the expressions of the hearts of people that I said before. So therefore, I would not want a secular humanist in the presidency because that's a bad religion, because it produces bad consequences.
Do you think Obama's a secular humanist?
Yes.
You don't think he claims to be a Christian?
I know, but he doesn't go to church. I mean, and the churches he did go into before were kind of wacko. And he kind of is the type that, you know, there's the shepherds and the sheep. So he's kind of been a sheep in terms of religion, and the shepherds he's latched onto, you know, like Reverend Wright, have not been very
okay,
good.
Okay, so if I would say there's a huge problem having a Mormon as a president because Mormonism is so easy to falsify. You might say, well, it's the same thing of having a secular humanist as president because it's easy to falsify?
No, I would say that Romney would have to be able to devoid himself of Mormonism as far as an expression of how he's going to run the office. Secular humanists don't do that. They actually try to mold the country into this into their morals and their exclusion of God in the evolution thing. So, I would want just somebody who, you know, what is a president supposed to do, and who can do that job well?
Well, I think ultimately everybody who's a president is going to try to mold the country with their moral outlook. I mean, because that's what they believe. So that's reasonable to expect that to happen.
But there's not necessarily. There's a moral outlook, but there's the economic outlook too. And you know, there's the checks and balances. There's a Congress, and there's the Supreme Court, you know, and there's the whole court system. So I don't think anybody could really get away with really changing the country completely without the feedback coming, because they're up for election again.
Well, so do you agree with me that Mormonism is easy to debunk? Do you know about the Book of Abraham thing?
No, you're the ex-Mormon.
I'm not an ex-Mormon, but I studied Mormonism a lot.
Oh, I thought you said you were Mormon.
No, but I studied Mormonism. No.
Oh. No, I'm
an ex-evangelical Christian,
like you. Oh, good. Yeah. I'm not ex. No. Yeah, oh, yeah, yeah. Let me see. No, I don't know Mormonism well. But the thing is that, like I said, there's the basic, you know, I love the Bible, I love I love God, I follow that. And that should be common amongst all the denominations. All that other stuff is theological. You know, and yeah, there are some people who have run with some weirdness, like the Mormons with the diapers and all that stuff. But
I mean, I don't know about diapers. I mean the underwear stuff.
Oh, I heard diapers. Yeah, but anyway, no. I mean, I don't know. I'm not speaking.
They have special undergarments to protect them from evil spirits.
Oh, yeah. Okay, so there's some weird stuff going on in all religions, though. You know, in all denominations.
Really? What's weird in your religion?
Let's see. What's weird in my religion? We'll talk about that some other time.
Okay. Self-disclosure, yeah.
Yeah. Well, how much time do we have, by the way?
Just about 10 minutes.
Okay, there's one I wanted to get to.
Okay, but one thing I just want to say is that you said it shouldn't be a theological thing. Well, my concern is that there's a fatal flaw in his critical thinking when, you know, exactly.
Well, how much
him,
do you know that he's buying into that stuff, though?
Well, from.
I mean, still, right
well,
now.
Well, it seems like he covered his tracks as far as there's not. If you look on the news and Google it, it's hard to find any information.
But if you compare it to Obama, it's just like it's horrible on Obama's side.
Well, as far as theology, I mean, Romney was what they call, he's high up. He was like, I can't remember what they call it, stake president or something, but
bishop or
something.
But he's not going to have the Congress wearing protective underwear. So he's not going to go.
No, but my concern is that it's so easy to debunk it. Because, see, what happens is there is a facsimile in the Book of Abraham. It shows a picture, and it shows, like, this altar with some Egyptian characters. And he goes, here's the translation. Abraham says blah, blah, blah. And it's like, no, that's not what it says.
You're right.
No,
I could find problems in every denomination, actually.
Not like that, though. I mean, this proves he was a liar when he says he's a prophet translating. This is not a translation.
Well, that's it. No, that's true. But, you know, I mean, how long does it take somebody to really find out what the truth is? And, you know, I mean, yeah, like
well, being
like
a Mormon,
I said,
though, he should know even more because, I mean, he should investigate his own beliefs.
Maybe he does. I mean, we're talking hypothetically because we don't know what he believes, really, and how strongly he believes in those things, so, and how much he would drag him into the presidency, whereas Obama has dragged some bad economic policies into the presidency that's hurt this country.
See, most people don't want to talk about this, but I really think it's fascinating because I talked to Mormon missionaries before, and the way I see it is they want to keep low, and, you know, a lot of times they'll just refer people to the website or something, and one time in debates I tried to get some Mormons, you know, in this, and they're like, well, we can't do anything. It's like, well, we're going to talk about Mormonism, and they'll say, well, say what you want. Well, our missionaries basically do the mop up, you know, And I found out they don't even have a seminary. They don't even teach like professional Mormons or anything.
That's true in most religions. So the formation, the Christian formation is really, really bad in this country, in all denominations pretty much. That's why I write the books. So
but they have seminaries though. I mean, like Catholics, yeah, and
I know,
Baptists,
but they don't come out. They don't come out too good. So I mean, they don't come out really solid. That's why I do what I do.
I found out the Mormon seminaries are really just to teach high school kids during the like release time and stuff.
When they go out and do their missions.
So anyway.
Yeah, there's two things I wanted to get to.
Okay,
one evolutionary and one personal.
Okay.